concern about how these stay-at-home orders and the pandemic are impacting mental health. Linda Gallagher of the Hamilton County Mental Health and Recovery Services Board is joining us this morning via Skype to talk about these issues. Thanks so much, Linda, for getting up early with us on a Saturday. I appreciate it.
Absolutely, Antoinette. Thank you.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about what your concerns are, what you all are hearing and seeing out in the community.
Sure. First, I want to let you know the Hamilton County Mental Health and Recovery Services Board, by law, is charged with planning, evaluating, and funding behavioral health services for residents of Hamilton County. And we contract with about 36 different agencies that provide alcohol and drug counseling, mental health treatment, as well as prevention services. And all of our providers are out there working in the community, they're in the schools, as well as some residential settings. And, you know, certainly this whole pandemic has been a disruption. Almost overnight, everyone in our provider network, in our recovery support system, had to figure out how do we stay connected with our clients? How do we stay connected with families and individuals who are experiencing anxiety, who have relied on us for ongoing treatment and support services, sometimes medication, to assist them with their behavioral health needs. Mm-hmm. So everybody has really stepped up. They've worked into figuring out telehealth. They're doing a lot more reaching out by phone. They're figuring out all the different platforms that you can use, whether that's Skype or there's all different kinds of platforms out there where everybody's still trying to make that connection. They're collaborating. They're being creative and innovative. You know, one of the things that the schools did was set up some centers where folks can pick up school books or packets as well as food. Mm-hmm. And so our providers have joined there to make sure that they're trying to make sure that families, individuals are aware the resources are out there. Our agencies are open and they are willing and ready to help anybody who needs it.
So are you hearing a lot from those providers that people are feeling? I mean, I'm obviously, if you're having mental health problems, this would exacerbate those, this whole situation.
Sure, absolutely, sure. It's been a disruption for folks who don't have severe mental illness or don't have a severe depression or anxiety. So you can imagine someone who suffers with severe anxiety on a regular basis, and suddenly so much of their connection, so much of their opportunities, they might have this perception of increased isolation, decreased access to the services and individuals that for support that they relied on. But yes, so our clients are worried. And additionally, we've had to decrease some of the beds that are available. Some of our residential services, you can't have two people in a room.
Right.
For the social isolation. Mm-hmm. So there's been a reduced capacity mm-hmm. for some of that access. So, everybody's working to the best of their ability to make sure that folks can get connected.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Linda. We're hoping everybody makes it through all of this okay. Thanks so much again for joining us this morning.
Thank you.